Hello, this is 13 Heathens, and today I'm going to be talking about that favorite topic of Anonymous, interpolation. And for the sake of this explanation, this empty glass, the empty space in it, is going to be representing what they refer to as theta, the spiritual energy, the positive spiritual energy. So the ideal situation would be for this glass to be empty, to have nothing but theta, no interpolated theta, which interpolated theta is caused by either mental or physical problems. Physical problems would be referred to as enmeshed, which is their representation for matter, energy, space, and time. Now, we're not going to worry about that. All we're going to worry about is that the water in this glass is going to be representing Entheta, which is basically that bad spiritual mojo, negative feelings, etc. And, of course, to make this so that it was plainly obvious, let's add a little bit of food coloring. I was originally thinking about putting in some nice volcano orange, but I ended up just picking green because, well, it's dark enough to be seen quite well. So, this is Entheta, this is Theta. Now, I'm going to explain this instead of using a standard analogy or what have you. I'm going to use this as my visual representation of the individual. Now, in accordance to their beliefs, the auditing and Dianetics will eventually get you clear of all your Entheta, all your bad feelings, etc., and turn you into a clear, much like this glass, which is clear of fluid. Well, even in the case of somebody who's supposedly clear, there's still going to be a degree of dun-dun-dun Entheta that's going to come along. For example, you're sitting there, you're walking down the street, and you see something that you find troubling. There's a news article talking about Scientology that's negative. The people in the church are sitting there and trying to audit the hell out of you. A bunch of protesters keep popping up out front. And all of this starts adding up, and you get more and more turmoil. Now, on top of those protesters being out front, whenever you sit there and try and ask somebody about it, they either don't answer or they call them terrorists and say they're trying to kill you. Now, simply saying that they're protesters and they don't understand what you believe wouldn't be too bad, you know, but once you start telling people that there are people outside that want to blow them up and kill them, yeah, you're going to be causing more stress. Of course, this is very beneficial to the cult, because once you have that much stress, they just get to audit it all the way and rebrainwash you back to their beliefs. Good for them, right? Well, we're a little bit below the 2.0 line still here on their tone scale, or I should say a little bit above, because I have this done upside down in relation to the way they do it. So you're heading towards zero here, therefore you're on your way to death, so they better audit you a little bit more real quick, you know, all that Entheta's not good for you. But, you know, you've seen the protesters and you're a little bit frustrated, so you still have a bit of Entheta going on here. You go home to talk to your nice supportive family of non-Scientologists about it, and they let you know they've seen a few things in the news about Scientology. Mentioned they've heard some things about Narconon as well. They even say that they've heard this whole Xenu story about this alien and ask you if you're in an alien cult. Needless to say, you're a little bit troubled by this. And of course, they do tell you, naturally, that they're only asking these things because they love you. And they care about you, and they're concerned about your well-being. You're still left a little bit troubled, though. So you rush back to your auditor, which is what any good Scientologist would do, and you say, you know, I've been having some problems with my family, can you help me? And they say, sure, fine, you're going to have to handle your family, what's the situation? And they say, oh, well, they might be suppressive. No, your family, they're not suppressive, they raised you, they're good people, right? But he reminds you, you are the Theta being. You are not the messed being. The messed being's just the shell in which you're Theta beings, and you're not really related to these people. So what you should really do is handle them. So, you know, you feel empowered and they give you your handling tips and they send you to go talk to your family. And your family says, what are you talking about? We don't understand any of this. You're using all these weird terms that don't make any sense to us. This church is clearly no good for you. And you talk to them about how wonderful Dianetics is and you try and convince them that Scientology is a great thing. At which point you find out that they've learned a few things about it and they've looked through the books and they say that it's utter rubbish. Oh, you certainly can't handle this now, can you? You know, your glass is dim, you're full, you're as frustrated as you think that you can be. Your family doesn't believe in Scientology. They believe that your beliefs are rubbish. So they go and they talk to the folks at their little church, and they say, okay, how can I handle this better? And they say, and the church says, ooh, I think your family's oppressive. You're going to have to disconnect. But that's okay, because you're not related, right? Now the problem is, as you can see by my spill here, there's always casualties when they do this. There's always that extra little bit that's always left behind waiting. But regardless, they then tell you you're going to need to disconnect. You can't deal with the stress of this, so they agree to take care of it for you. Because after all, they're just oppressive people, and you're trying to save the world, right? After all, you're going to make it a better place. And they're going to hold you, and they're going to interrogate you for hours and hours, and make sure that everything's going well with you and their way of looking at things. Because you want to be clear, you want all your problems to go away, don't you? Self-fulfilling prophecy, they make the problems, then they claim to cure them. Well, after a while, you start feeling a bit better. You get letters from your family saying that, you know, your sister's just gotten married, but, you know, she suppresses, so you're not supposed to talk to her. And you're invited to the wedding, you can't go, and you're troubled by this. Well, the church steps in and says, you don't need this needless Entheta. We'll take care of your correspondence for you. We'll make all your troubles go away. And they essentially sequester you and keep you away from all those that care about you and love you and would try to get you away from a group that they feel is destructive. But in the meantime, you're feeling pretty good. You have most of the stress taken care of, but you still have doubts because deep buried in the back of your mind, no matter how clear you may think you are, there's always this right here, right under the glass. Just waiting. All those feelings about your family and realizations that you betrayed their love and trust in you. This group has torn you away from the people that care about you most. And the years will pass, and you'll have your good times and your bad. But over time, as you get further and further, you'll start learning more and more about it, especially after you start going broke and you're indoctrinated into Sea Org, and you start getting deeper and deeper into the cult and learning what's really going on there deep inside. Then you start finding out about the Xenu story, and you start dealing with people and finding out about censorship and them monitoring your messages while you're on the phone. And then once you start thinking about your family again, you start wondering, what have I missed? And then you're sent to RPF for having too many questions. And they try to brainwash you all over again. But each time, it's less and less effective. Then one day you say, you know what? This isn't the way. This isn't clear. This isn't freedom. And this time you don't tell anyone. And you just sit there and watch as your stress and your turmoil gets more and more. Maybe even realize that you've learned more about the hard times than the good. And you blow. But you know what? Once you blow, find out that all they've said about how horrible the world isn't true. Find your way and again reunite with your family. You end up more free and more clear than you ever really were with the cult. That is pretty much a visual summary of how interpolation works according to the cult of Scientology. Have yourselves a good day.